In this sewing tutorial, I want to talk about safety pins, types, sizes, and how to use them. What once was used for very simple purposes is now an essential multi-purpose tool every sewist needs. So, these are the types of safety pins I'm going to show. Traditional, curved, wonder pins, heavy duty or skirt kilt safety pins, bulb, button safety pins, decorative safety pins. Traditional. These are the safety pins that come to mind when you think of safety pins with the locking head that keeps everything in place and prevents pin pricks. They can be used for quilting, sewing and crafting. The pins can also range in size from 3/4 inch to 4 inches long. Let me show you how to use safety pins for turning tubes of fabric right side out. This tip is not new to experienced sewists, but for those new to sewing, this method may be a huge time saver. A traditional safety pin is the perfect tool to turn those narrow tubes of fabric right side out. Here is how. Start by inserting your safety pins through only one layer of your fabric from the outside to the inside. Close your safety pin and slide the head into the fabric tube. Once your pin is completely inside the fabric tube, gather your fabric over the pin while holding the pin in one hand. After you get a good gathering of fabric, gently pull the gathers of the pin on the opposite end. This step is more difficult for very narrow fabric tubes, so you may need to be patient and just keep pulling away at it. Continue repeating the process until the safety pin comes out on the opposite end of your tube. Traditional safety pins are used for inserting elastic. There are times when you will want to use elastic. Sometimes we don't want to sew elastic directly into the garment. Sewing a casing is a great way to get the fit you want. But the downside is that you will need to find a way to thread the elastics through once you have sewn your casing. There are specialty tools you can use, but I prefer to use a handy safety pin for this task. Here is how to do it. Push the pin into your casing. As you slide the pin forward, you will see the fabric gathering over the pin. Pull the excess fabric back behind the pin. Repeat this process again and again to keep advancing the safety pin until it appears at the other end of the casing. Every now and then the pin may open as you are threading it through the casing. When this happens, you may be able to just close it back up and keep moving forward. Take care not to accidentally pin the fabric as you do this. Worst case scenario, pull the pin back out and start all over again. Feel the fabric as you go to ensure that it doesn't twist. Once you get all the way through the other side, do a quick double check before securing the ends. If the elastic is twisted, simply twist the safety pin to straighten it out. The next type of safety pins, curved safety pins. The curved band allows this pin to easily pass through many layers of fabric. This makes it a great tool for basting quilts and other situations where you have multiple layers of fabric to hold in place. This safety pin style ensures that the layers don't shift. The curve is specifically designed to grab just the right amount of fabric and come back through the layer so you can close the pin easier. So use only safety pins that are specially designed for basting quilts. They have the single angled side that allows you to poke down through the top of your fabric and back up again. that angled side makes pins basting much easier because it eliminates the bunching of the fabric on the bottom side. Basting pins are also super sharp, and some use thinner metal to slide through multiple fabrics much more easily. But let me show you something you may not have heard of: wonder pins. Well, I used in my sewing projects wonder tape, wonder clips, and now they also made wonder pins. Did you hear about all these wonders? So, what are wonder pins? They feature a plastic covered top that's easy to handle. Their bright colors are easy to find and remove. The angled side and super sharp tip make pins basting easy. Clever wonder pins are an innovative solution to pin basting because they are sturdy and sharp, yet thin enough not to leave large holes in your fabrics. On their package it's written open and close with one hand. Well, I am trying to do it, but I guess I need more practice. It's the very first time I am using this. I am successfully inserting them with one hand, but to close, not so much, only after a few tries. It's important to note that you will want to use a flat surface that's used to wear. Don't use your best dining room table for pin basting, because the pins may scratch the finish as you poke them down through the top of the fabric. I am using my patio table, so I'm safe. The design leverages the benefits of both safety pins and straight pins. They feature brightly colored plastic covers that are both easy to handle and easy to find on your quilt. Plus, they are heavy, strong, and sharp enough to use with multiple or heavy fabrics, but also thin enough to not leave holes in your fabric. At least big holes. Bulb pins. This type of safety pin has a bulb or pear shape. It's mostly used to attach tags and labels to garments and quilts, but bulb pins also great to use for craft projects and general household use. Can also be used for knitting and crochet projects. Heavy duty safety pins or skirt kilt pins. These pins are thick, sturdy, strong, safe, not easy to bend, but they are not as sharp as a regular safety pin. They have a more ornamental design also. They are used, for example, to keep a blanket in place in a duvet cover or to keep a bed skirt in place. Sometimes they are called skirt kilt safety pins since it's a decorative pin used to hold kilts closed. Button pins. These safety pins are not that popular, but some people like using them. The button style of safety pins has a small bump in the middle that can hold non-washable delicate shank buttons in place on a garment. These pins are made to hold shank buttons or on garments without sewing, either as an emergency fix or to use a button as a brooch, or to attach a delicate button to a sweater or other garment so it can be easily removed for cleaning. And finally, decorative safety pins. Decorative safety pins are kind of costume jewelry. You can use these pins for many things, for example, to hold together a dress slit that is a little too high, or a top cut too low, or if you want to add a little bling to your outfit. Many women use them for scarves. Not all safety pins are created equal. If you want to have a good quality safety pins for your sewing projects, you should look for these features. Made of premium stainless steel, nickel-plated or brass, rust-resistant, corrosion-resistant, have sharp points that don't break the fabric and don't leave holes in the fabric. Don't bend even if inserted through thick layers of fabric, and last through multiple projects.